I would want to thank our Honorable Home Minister for efficiently and effectively dealing with this Delhi riots and containing it within 36 hours. Within 36 hours. Sir, the opposition may cry horse. But there are two or three issues that I would want to bring to the attention of this House. Because the objective of this debate must not be to blame pin on each other, but primarily to understand why riots are taking place and how collectively as a house, as a country, as a government, all of us collectively can stop these riots that are so repeatedly occurring in this country. So allow me a minute to go into the history of how there is in place a Congress module of riot engineering in this country, which has from the last so many decades tried to engineer riots in this country so that it benefits them politically. And this is not a thing of today, sir. This has happened not from today, but from the last 70 years since the time of our independence. Let me just give a few examples, sir. Sir, from 1950 to 1964, under the Prime Ministership of Jawaharlal Nehru, 243 communal violence incidences were recorded in India. Under Indira Gandhi's rule, sir, 337 communal violence incidences were documented in 15 states. Sir, during Rajiv Gandhiji's rule, 291 communal violence incidences were documented in 16 states, sir, including the barbaric Sikh pogrom of 1984. Sir, out of the 1,194 communal violence incidents documented in India from 1950 to 1995, 73% of all of these occurred during the Nehru, Indira and the Rajiv Gandhi Prime Ministership. Sir, the nation wants to know why all these years the Congress party engineers this riot to benefit itself politically. Sir, let me... Sir, there is a reason why I have congratulated the Honorable Home Minister, sir. Within 36 hours, a detailed conspiracy, which had taken more than 3 months for preparation and execution, was curtailed and controlled. Let me explain what this module of the Congress conspiracy is, the Congress module of riot engineering is. Sir, right after the CAA was passed by this Honorable House, in the most democratic manner, the Congress President Sonia Gandhi addresses a gathering in the Ram Leela Maidan and knowing fully well that the CAA has nothing whatsoever to do with citizenship of Indian Muslims or any Indians whatsoever, misleads the entire nation and gives a call for Kurbani and says, "Aar par ki ladai," and she says the people should come out of houses and come out on streets. The very next day, sir, the very next day, Shaheen Bagh protests start and hundreds of innocent Muslim women misled, incited, they come out onto the streets, sir, and they are used as shields by all these radical Islamist outfits supported by the Congress ecosystem to further their agenda of breaking this country. So what happens the very next day? Sir, young students in Jamia Millia University, the Jawaharlal Nehru University, supported by SFI, SDPI and other such cohorts, start organizing violent protests. What are the slogans raised? Too much has been discussed about Kapil Mishra's so-called hate speech, sir. But I would want to draw the attention of the House just to the slogans that were raised during the protest. Jinnawali Azadi. What is this Jinnawali Azadi? Hindu on se azadi, kafir on se azadi. These were the slogans that were raised in these protests, sir. And what was the other slogan? Sir, let me tell you, there is nothing anti-Muslim about the CAA, but there is everything anti-Hindu about the anti-CAA protests. What was the slogan that was raised? Tera mera rishta kya? La ilaha illallah. These were the slogans that were raised at these protests, sir. And those who were slaying these slogans, those who were perpetrating this violence, were portrayed as victims by the intellectual jihadis who write for this ecosystem in the newspapers. And these people who raise these slogans of Tukde Tukde of Bharat, of Kafiron Se Azadi, they were given an impression that they were victims of police brutality. And people called them Shiros. Shiros. This is how a narrative was built, sir. And the entire ecosystem started functioning. Let me give you two more examples of how this ecosystem functions. Sir, Harsh Mandar, whose links today have been exposed to global funds which are anti-India, based out of US, Hungary and Italy. Sir, give me a couple of more minutes, sir. These organizations, these people who claim to be the champions of constitutional morality, go onto the streets and incite an innocent mob and say, Supreme Court will not give you justice, but justice must be fought for on the streets. Ironically, they approach the Supreme Court themselves to book cases against Hindu leaders. Sir, not just that, look at how the international media plays this out. As if on cue, sir, 17th of February, knowing fully well that 24th February, Donald Trump is coming to India, Umar Khalid makes a speech, exhorts the minority community to go onto the streets and start violent protests so that they can give out a message to Donald Trump. Sir, this is not a first instance. When in 2015, Barack Obama visited India, again there was a bogey of the church riots that happened again in Delhi. So the question must be asked, why only Delhi? Why only Delhi and not other places in the country? Sir, it is precisely because they want to defame the Prime Minister and the Honorable Home Minister, under whom the Delhi Police Authority comes, sir. And that is the conspiracy behind it. Sir, Donald Trump comes here. International media starts spinning this news. And who is supporting this, sir? Sir, there is a prominent journalist, J. Gopi Krishnan, who a couple of days ago made it public that he was offered $1,500 to write an article, 1,000 word long, defaming India by an international publication. And immediately thereafter, sir, Bernie Sanders, who is a card-carrying socialist, also speaks against India. And all of these are orchestrated in such a manner to prevent a negative image of this country, sir. And why? It is precisely, sir, because India should not get the high seat of table at the United Nations Security Council. That India should not emerge as a global power in the Asian region. And this is done at the behest of the Chinese and the Pakistani forces that are at play. Sir, I would want to just bring two more very important notes. Sir, why this whole thing is becoming such a big issue? Sir, for the last 70 years.
एक मिनट. हाँ, क्या पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर है? क्या पॉइंट ऑफ ऑर्डर?
सर, रूल 352 रूल्स टू बी ऑब्जर्व्ड व्हाइल स्पीकिंग. मेंबर व्हाइल स्पीकिंग.
352 रूल्स.
मेक अ पर्सनल रेफरेंस बाय मेकिंग एन एलिगेशन इंप्यूटिंग अ मोटिव. सर, सोनिया गांधी जी के बारे में सर.
Sir, it's a speech that is on record and the rules permit me to make the speech it is a published fact. Sir, the last 70 years.
एक मिनट बैठिए, आप भी बैठिए. सदन एक दिन तय कर ले कि हमें 352 का रूल का पालन करना है. मैं उस दिन से सदन 352 के रूल के पालन से चला दूंगा. सदन सहमत है? विचार कर लो आप. सदन शपथ पूर्ण कहते हैं 352 का रूल का पालन होना चाहिए. मैं सदन में पीठ से कह रहा हूं, मैं उस रूल के तहत सदन चला सकता हूं. सहमति दे तो चले.
सर, टू मच हैज बीन स्पोकन रिपीटेडली बोथ इनसाइड एंड आउटसाइड ऑफ दिस हाउस ऑन द एलिजेड हेट स्पीच ऑफ कपिल मिश्रा. So what did Kapil Mishra say? He said he gave an ultimatum to the police authorities that in 3 days, if you don't clear, things will not be in control. Is this a hate speech? Sir, I will tell you with all confidence, sir, no jurisdiction and no jurisprudence in any part of the world will consider this hate speech. But let me give you an example of what hate speeches were, sir. And I will give you only a sample of them.
Sir,
Amanatullah Khan of the Aam Aadmi Party was caught on camera, sir. Sir, 2 minute mein conclude karunga. Sir, 2 minute mein conclude karunga. Sir, 2 minute mein conclude karunga, sir. But these are things which must be brought to the attention of this house, sir, out of the government. Sir, Amanatullah Khan of the Aam Aadmi Party spoke at Jama Masjid at an anti-CAA glari, sir. He said, We merely number 25 to 30 crores but they are still so scared. If we are only even 72, we are ready to kill 15 crore. What does this mean? What does this mean, sir? Was this brought to the attention of the house? Sir, not just that. Sir, not just that.
Please conclude.
Sir, videos were made. Sir, videos were made, sir, of young children saying, we will kill Narendra Modi, we will kill Amit Shah. Young children, this is the radicalization that has happened in this country.